A warm welcome to all the listeners of Voice of Saints. Today, 26 January, the World Catholic Church celebrates the feast of St. Timothy and Titus. The New Testament contains two letters addressed to Timothy and one to Titus, the three being referred to collectively as the pastoral epistles. Both are referred in the Acts of Apostles and in letters certainly written by Paul, indicating that they were connected with him. In Acts, Timothy is described as the son of a Jewish woman who was a believer, but his father was a Greek man. Later tradition recorded by the historian Eusebius made Timothy bishop of Ephesus, and Acts of St. Timothy written in Ephesus in the 4th or 5th century gives an account of his martyrdom. He was killed by the pagan folk opposing their festivals at the feast of Dionysius. Paul took Timothy as a companion and had him circumcised to make him acceptable to Jewish Christians. He went with Paul to Macedonia and from there came to Corinth. Arriving at the time, Paul was turning his back on the Jews and resolving, "From now on, I will go to the Gentiles." Paul then sent him back to Macedonia with Erastus, while he himself stayed on in Asia. He was later in Greece with Paul and others, returned to Syria by the way of Macedonia after a plot against them. Titus accompanied Paul on the journey to Jerusalem that led to be known as the Council of Jerusalem. There Paul won the day, arguing that Gentiles should not be subjected to the Mosaic law before becoming Christians. In accordance with this, he did not insist that Titus, who was a Greek, should be circumcised. Titus went to Corinth to encourage the Corinthians, as their poorer brothers in Macedonia were. After death, his body was supposedly buried at Gortina in Crete. The head was detached and taken to Venice in 823. Timothy and Titus both are called loyal child in the letters addressed to them. They both dedicated their lives to Jesus. The love of Christ sustained them. On behalf of St. Franz Association, I wish you all happy feast day. Thank you.